In this video, I will show you how to design and implement real-time data extraction in Talend. For this example, I'll be making use of ActiveMQ, which is one of the queuing and messaging platform. And this is from the Apache, so it is open source and it's free to use. So let's see how this can be done in Talend. Here is the high-level architecture and data flow diagram for easier understanding. So let's say in our use case, we have a Java or .NET based web portal, right? And users are using that web portal to enter reservation data. So in this scenario, if you want to do a real-time analysis, what we could possibly do is Talend can directly connect to this database, source database, and pull the data and perform any data analytics. But this is not a best practice at all. This is because, you know, it might have a lot of negative impacts on the application itself, right? Talend or any other ETL tool can create a lock or create, you know, performance issues or blocking or some sort of issues might happen on the source side and the entire business will be down, right? So in order to avoid that situation and also do the real-time analytics, you know, in parallel, we could possibly introduce some applications, you know, that's called as queuing or messaging system, right? So there are, so this is this part, and there are several applications and tool available in the market. For this demonstration, I'll be making use of ActiveMQ, right? It's an open source from Apache Foundation, and it's very quick and you know, quick to set up, install and set up, and make use of it in Talend, right? The other applications, namely, you know, RabbitMQ, or you have Kafka, and you have several other, you know, applications. But let's concentrate on ActiveMQ in this demo. I'll be showing how to install and set it up so that you can, you know, use it in Talend, right? So this application, most of the messaging system works on publisher and subscriber model. What it means is, in our case, this web portal is sending the data, right? It's producing the data, right? So this is the producer. And in our case, Talend is a consumer, right? So there will be a queue or topics created in the application system. And this web portal will be sending data to a particular queue or a topic. And Talend will be always listening to that queue or topic, right? We will look at one of the example here in our hands-on in a minute. But so that's the, you know, concept. You have a producer and you have a consumer, and it's in real time. And the advantage of having the application for queuing or messaging is, so let's say Talend goes down or any system goes down and you connect it after, let's say, 1 hour, what this will do is it will hold those messages in queue, right? There are FIFO queues available. So let's say there are 10 reservations. Those 10 will be residing in this queuing you know, system. And as soon as the Talend application is back online, and when we hit this queue, we will be able to, you know, extract those messages in the same fashion as they are entered into the system, right? So this is the concept here. And the modern queuing applications will also, you know, work on a cluster-based, you know, distributed, and there are a lot of new features. I'll make a separate video for Kafka and, you know, Kinesis in the upcoming you know, videos. But for this, let's stick on to this ActiveMQ. And inside Talend, we can connect to this queue and extract the data. And from there, we can either, you know, load it to a queue or send it to, you know, directly to the reporting wherein you can do any sort of analysis. So let's get started and see how this can be, you know, set on this Talend side. Alright, first thing first, we will have to download this ActiveMQ first. For that, we will just type in ActiveMQ download, and you will have the suggestions from Apache org. Go ahead and click on that, and the latest version is ActiveMQ 5, and go ahead and download this particular link. If it is Windows or if it is Linux, you go ahead and use this this one. So let's go ahead and click on this. So this will download the file. It is about 62 MB. Once this is downloaded, go ahead and unzip the file. the downloaded file. Once you unzip, you will find a folder something called as Apache with the respective version, right? So under that you will have bin and also web app, and there will be a executable jar file. So this is very important, just pay attention here. So once you have this folder extracted, go to bin, and if it is Windows 64, go ahead and click on install service. This is very quick one, it just disappears so fast, and you will have the ActiveMQ service installed here, right? So this is the services on Windows side. Go ahead and just do a right click and then start it. So in my case it's already running, right? So once this is done, when you go to the browser, right, you will have the port number would be 8161. So when you click on, when you enter localhost colon 8161, you will be getting this page. So this is the admin console for ActiveMQ. And if you notice, there is a section called queues, there's a topics, subscribers, connections, and even scheduled, scheduler is also part of it. So let's not worry on all those. So in order to create any queue, what you could do is just click on queue name, type in the queue name that you want to create, and go ahead and click on create. Right, so it's very simple to set it up. And likewise, if you want to create a separate topic, you can go ahead and just type in the topic name and then create. So a topic is created and also a queue is created. In this video, I will choose a topic. Okay, I'll choose this topic and I'll pass the data, and we will extract it in real time. And if you remember this, our application, our web application, will put the order details, right? Whatever it is, order details or reservation details, onto this application. So we don't have this part on the Java, but what I have is I have an Excel that contains the data. So here is the sample data. Through in this we have customer ID, customer name, and then the product and price. So let's say this is one particular record. What I will do is, instead of sending it in a Java way, I'm going to send this in a record manually. Okay, so the way you send the data is using there is a send to link, or you can even click on this topic, go to topic and click on this topic name, and if you scroll down, there is a message body here. So I'll put this XML directly on the body, and you can hit send. And if you notice here, so there is one message enqueued, but it's not dequeued yet. So this particular order detail is still in the queue. You can put as many records as you want. And this will show 2, 3, 4, 5, in the increasing number. Okay, so this is how you will actually add the data into a particular topic. On the talent side, so we have a component called as JMS input. So it is also available in OpenStudio. Go ahead and pull this component on the job design area. And initially, when you pull this, it'll ask you to download some jar files. Go ahead and do that. Once that is done, you will have this module list emptied. All you can do is just click on this and go to install a new model. Go to the location where you have unzipped the ActiveMQ, right? So this is the file we need to choose it here. Right, once this is chosen, it will show up on the module list, and there is no change to the context provider here, right? We're not changing the provider and the server URL, but if you have a remote server, you can put those remote server host name here, and no change to this. And also for the message type, so this is where I was talking, you can configure to read the messages either from a topic or from a queue, right? You have the selection for those two. Now that we have added the XML to the topic, so I'll choose topic, and message from is the name of the topic that is created. Okay, So we will have to enter this, and if you want to set some timeout, you can actually set those, and also you can set the limit for maximum messages, right? And the important thing here is the processing mode. So there are two processing mode, either a raw message or message content. So raw message will actually contain all other details as well. So for example, all these details will also come. These are some of the extended feature you can, you know, as and when you learn, you can actually do play along. But for this example, I have directly chosen message content. So message content is nothing but only this part of it, right? Whatever we have entered here, only this part will be extracted. Okay, and the schema will be just the message content, right? That's all you need on JMS input. And once this is done, since we are passing XML, let's go ahead and bring in the XML component. So this, for this, I'll be making use of textract XML field component. And if you look at our XML file here, so it is starts with order, right? Order, and there are four columns here: customer ID, name, product, and price. The same thing is already entered here on the XPath. Right, and I have given some name to it. So once we have this XML component created and configured, go ahead and click on main using the main connections. Right, you can just choose to no, and this will automatically detect. Because what will happen is, on target side we want four different columns, but on a source side we have only one column. Correct. So that's why we need to hit no. Otherwise, what would happen is the schema will actually change. Okay. So once this extract XML field is ready, you can actually connect from here to a database output or a file output or whatever it is. But for this demo, I'll make it quick and use tlog row here. Now let's go ahead and connect it using main. Okay, so now it is done. Let's go ahead and run this particular job now. Okay, so there are a couple of warnings here. And also, if you notice, this JMS component is something, it'll always, you know, have your talent job running in a running mode, so that whenever there is a new data, it'll grab it and process that data throughout your talent job. So this is the real-time feature, inside Talend. Okay, so now ready to receive message and it is waiting. So let's go ahead and enter some data on our JMS queue. So this XML is copied and click on send. Okay, so one message is sent. And now if you see, now that the Talend job is running, under number of consumers, it will show one. Which means there is one already a JMS connection which is treated as consumer. Okay. And there are two messages in the enqueued format on the enqueued column. So there is one consumer which is already listening to this, but the newly entered record will now show it up on the talent job. See, the one record is entered here and it is processed. And here is the output from the tlog row. I have put the these two windows side by side so that I can enter data on the right hand side and you will be able to see the output coming, right? So let me go ahead and enter this topic. I'll go to this topic, click on this, and I'll copy the second record. Okay, I'll go ahead and enter it here and then send. So as soon as that is sent, you will see the new record already entered, right? So similarly, you can actually enter another data. So let's say there is three is coming and hit send, and the third one is red, right? So this is how, if the web application sending the latest reservation data to a particular queue, and that data will be read in real time inside your talent job. So this is how you can set up real-time data extraction using ActiveMQ.